pop it and the skin goes...
I do think the sun is good for you. I don't think, you know, it's totally terrible, but, you know,
people just have to be careful.
They should start selling sun creams and promoting the fact that they do actually make you brown and keep you brown.
It does. It makes the tan last longer
as
well.
It does, yeah.
OK, we've lots more televisual sunshine still to come. After the break, what rating would us loose ladies give our bodies out of 10? Back soon. Welcome back to more Monday Loose News and Views, bringing sunshine into your living room today alongside me, Andrea McLean, our Coleen Nolan, Carol McGiffin and Sherrie Hewson. We're going to be chatting to Chef Gary Rhodes shortly, and in an interview over the weekend, he was asked to rate his body out of 10. Although he reckoned overall he'd give himself about 5, on a good day, he could score 12 out of 10. Yes. So, we're all wearing skimpier clothes because of the sunshine. Where would you reckon your body is in a 1 to 10 kind of thing?
Well, everybody knows I have a slight problem with my body. I mean, I've always rated... About 3,
what's
I would
problem?
Say. Well, because the thing is...
And
No, it's
for
just
your
that...
Age.
Here we go. See, now that's what happened.
She would have said it to me.
I would, that's true.
Yeah.
The thing is, though, about 14, I thought, yeah, I'm OK, you know, like, everything's tucked and sucked and tight and...
age 14 and, or size 14?
Age 14.
Age 14.
But now, you know, as you get older, don't you, you look in the mirror and you go, who's that? Don't you? And you think, where has that other person gone? And that other person's disappeared and this other person's arrived. And I don't like it as much. And I look at my body and I think, but everything was tucked up before.
Yeah, but you were 14.
Yeah, yeah. 14.
I know. It's hard to cope with that. I mean, I think clothes as well, you know, like now it's summer. That is really hard for me because you've got the skimpy tops with the arms. We've all got the arms.
Well, hopefully we have, yeah.
Yes, and then you've got the skimpy
bottoms.
You can't need them to lift your pine. And then you've got, you know, the thighs. And then you've got the bum. And then you've got everything else.
What about the face?
The face.
You've had surgery on your face.
Yes, you see,
now... Did that make you feel better?
I did have surgery. But the thing is, and I have to tell you, I had it because I wanted to look in the mirror and see somebody else. I didn't want to see me. And then, but the awful thing
who
is...
Who did you want to see?
Anybody else. Julia Roberts, preferably.
Yeah,
but then
that,
I looked small.
That's more than... body issues, I think.
Yeah, that's
you not liking
self-esteem. But the
and
problem
I think that's
is...
the thing. I think if you've got self-confidence,
yeah.
It doesn't really matter how big or how small you are. If you're a confident person...
Where would you rate yourself?
Oh. Well, you know, a couple of years ago, like Sherrie, body-wise, probably 2 or 3, because I never really looked in the mirror. That's the secret.
Yes,
don't look in
don't
it. You don't have
it,
to
right.
acknowledge it. But now, because I've got my act together and I'm, you know, I'm eating healthy and exercise and all that, and my body shape is changing.
Yeah.
Now, confidence-wise, this isn't what I think other people think. This is what I confidence-wise, it's made me like a 6 or a 7 now, just
which
in confidence.
Nice.
As in,
and I know what you
I'm
mean.
Not scared anymore of seeing myself in the mirror.
In terms of the exercise, because I'm kind of getting a bit of an exercise buzz at the moment. Steve and I have been exercising together. He's lost 2 stone.
Wow.
Which is, and even he's starting to sort of, you know, walk a bit like this. We went out on Saturday and he didn't have a belly in the way. He was looking all good. And I would sort of rate myself, six or seven now.
Or seven.
Sort of creeping up.
Wise.
Miss McGiffin, I'm afraid to ask.
No, honestly, I wouldn't, I'm not a 10. I'm really not.
Oh, good.
No one's disagreeing with that.
No, you are.
No,
I know I'm not, but I mean, I do actually see myself, if I had to rate my... I would say I was about an 8, actually, for my age, and I don't mind saying that, because for 48, I'm really not in that bad shape.
You're not.
At the moment, I'm probably, you know, a bit less than that. I could normally be a 9, but I'm a bit overweight at the moment. I've got carrying a few extra pounds because I've been on holiday and I've been overdoing it and I've, you know, been larging it a bit too long. But, you know, it wouldn't take much. If I were like you and I could be bothered to do exercise and go to the gym, mm-hmm. like you two do, I could easily be a 10. So I'll just stay being an 8.
Right, good for you.
Good.
us are ordering takeaways rather than eating out at restaurants in a bid to beat the credit crunch. Speaking of which, Sherrie Hewson, you'll find out later. Well, our first guest is a pioneer of television cookery shows, and for his latest series, he's been busy travelling around China to look at the origins of some of our favourite Chinese dishes.
We're also surprised by the way ingredients arrive for cooking. Fish and seafood turn up alive, chicken still with the heads and claws. A bit shocking to our Western ideas, but that's just the way it is. I'm sure we'll get used to it. So what to cook? We're spoilt for choice here with so many great Cantonese recipes to pick from. But
there's one special dish we're going to be looking at today, in fact a special sauce, which is XO sauce.
Invented in the 1980s, this sauce is named after XO brandy, meaning extra old. It's been a huge success story. Once found only in high-class restaurants, it's now seen everywhere and is served with fish, meat and tofu. It's become a staple, but every chef has their own subtly different recipe. They're all based on dried seafood, chili, and garlic.
Please welcome Gary Rhodes.
Hello. Hi, ladies.
I'm so jealous of you.
What?
Was that in Shanghai, that bit?
No, that was Hong Kong.
Was it Hong Kong?
Hong Kong. Absolutely fantastic there. Couldn't believe it, you know. But going over there, I thought that really Cantonese food was all there was in China. Mm. But then, of course, going over the whole of the country, seeing such a different style in every place that you went, phenomenal.
Did you like Shanghai? You were there, weren't you?
Well, I want to ask you a question, actually, Carol. Can I have one of those snogs?
Me.
Oh, exactly.
Yeah, that's
exactly.
A first for a few weeks.
Oh, now, where was I? Chinese food, yes.
Gary, obviously feeling pretty confident there.
Well, you know, something like that.
So how would you rate her, then? A 12 out of 10, like yourself?
Oh, there's no question about it.
And well, just after, 12.
You know, looking's one thing, tasting is something else.
I'm getting a hot flush. Stop it.
Now, Gary, did you really say when you were asked to rate your body, you were a 12 out of 10 on a good day?
Okay, we all know what journalists are like, yes. You know, and he says, how do you rate yourself? And I said, well, I probably, you know, I said, you can't ask me that. Everybody else has to be the judge, you know. I said, but probably 5 out of 10, but I said, on a good day, 12 out of 10, yeah. As a joke, yeah, you know. Yeah.
I just want to ask the same joke.
What do you think?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You're in good shape, I have to say.
Very good shape.
But you
spend a lot
hard.
Of time.
I work out about 5 or 6 days a week. You know, I've become obsessed with it. I can't help it.
How do you fit that in? Because you've got such a busy lifestyle anyway. Do you have to get up
it's
at a ridiculous
very,
hour?
Very, very early. Yeah, I'm up, you know, about 4:30 in the morning and I'm working out by 5 o'clock.
That's
yeah.
Endorphins, you
oh,
see.
Oh, look at that. Yes.
Taking you over.
Wow.
Nice.
Look at you.
Oh, dear. It's true, it's true.
You wish you'd snogged him more now.
I had my chance, I blew
but
it.
But do you find that you work better, you've got more energy and this sort of thing? Is that why you do it? Or
there's
is
no
it, or
question
is it a
about
thing?
That. No question about it. You know, after working out, then, you know, you jump in that shower, you feel fantastic. Mm. And then I feel very positive. Right, now, let's attack the day. I'm wide awake. It just gives me a fresh sort of burst of energy and this boost. It's phenomenal.
You've got a gym in your house?
I've got a little gym. I say a few workout little bits and pieces.
You can't actually got to go to a gym, it's...
Oh, I couldn't do that. I know that I wouldn't want to go there and sort of queue up with everybody else and, you know, be quite embarrassed. And it's usually too hot. I have a very cold room at home, a couple of little bits and pieces, and I just work out.
Well, I must admit, I've got all your books. I love your food, everything. And whenever you're doing your programs, you always look so enthusiastic, and I'm always with you. But do you eat that food? Do you eat as healthily as you cook?
Oh, I'm not so sure about that. You know, the funny thing is that when you're cooking, you know, you take around your little spoon. I'm tasting away, thinking, oh, I need a squeeze of lemon, touch of salt, whatever it happens to be, and so I get so enthusiastic about that. Then, you know, I'm obsessed with that, and I really, it just drives me on. But then, you know, throughout the day, I'll suddenly realise I haven't actually eaten a meal because all I've done is taste and taste and taste and taste. And it does affect your appetite a little bit. But at weekends, oh goodness me, do I eat? I really do, and I don't think so much about. Yeah, I say the healthy. I mean, we always try to be a little bit careful. We don't overdo it at home. But we eat out an awful lot. And where do we go? We go to Chinese restaurants. We love it.
Do
yeah,
you?
That's well, one what, of the what that's sort why of things do
you
go.
Eat? Because you can eat Chinese food healthy. People only think of the deep fried things and the, you know, the prawn balls and pork balls and all this sort of thing. But you can eat healthy, can't you?
You can. I mean, there was one dish that I cooked over there, and a dish that I love eating, and it's just a sea bass which is steamed just above some water that's got ginger and spring onion in it. Then once it's cooked, they put more spring onion, just finely shredded, on top of the fish. And they pour a little bit of hot oil on top, just vegetable oil. And I said, what on earth are you doing that for? And it was simply the fact that it quickly cooks the spring onion, and that then gets into the flesh, and you just get this little aroma of that onion bite. And then little soy sauce, very healthy. Absolutely delicious.
Oh, you're a big pudding man, aren't you? I mean, your puddings are known.
I have a confession.
You know your hot American cheesecake?
Oh, yes.
Which I just is to die for. If I make it at home, I do try and say it's mine. But then I have to say it's yours because it's so obvious. That is the most erotic.